Hello, everybody. Welcome to Absent Minds. My name is Shad. This is Shad Spoils. And today, I'm going to be making my top 10 best movies of the year. And these is top 10 best movies of 2021. And whatever I say goes. So whatever you have on your top 10, doesn't matter. It's all about me. All right, I'm just kidding though. These are just my movies that I watched this year that I thought were amazing. There's a shit ton of movies this year. I have not seen every single movie this year. Like Dune, I haven't even watched that. I have no interest in watching it. So it's not gonna be on this list, just so you know. Like, I don't know. I just don't care to watch that movie at all. No matter how much people tell me it's great. I'm not interested. Sorry if it's like on your list, but it ain't all mine, Chief. Just wanted you to know. All right. A movie to make my top 10 is just like something I would go and see multiple times. Easily see multiple times, for sure. Like, it has to have some type of replay value, for me, at least. And it also has to be like intriguing, a little bit thought-provoking, like makes me like, damn, that's fucking crazy.
10.
So my number 10 movie is relatively new. It is The Internals. Alright? Internals, Marvel's The Internals. I didn't get to review this one because I kinda ran out of time. After watching it, this movie made me enjoy Marvel again, if that makes sense. Marvel was sort of getting a little stale, especially with Black Widow and the Shang-Chi. Even though Shang-Chi was cool, but it didn't hit for me. But like, Internals really kind of was like, this could be it. This could be where Marvel kind of brings shit around. Because if this leads to like some like Galactus type shit, I'm on board. So we'll see. But yeah, Eternals was really good. Thoroughly enjoyed that. Made me want to go watch it again. I do kind of want to watch it again. I know most people kind of shitted on it. Whatever, I enjoyed it. Fuck those people. Number 9 is going to be King Richard with Will Smith, actually. This is hard to make this list, to be honest with you. It was tough. I was like throwing a lot of these movies up and down throughout the entire list. But number 9 is King Richard with Will Smith. You know, Venus and Serena Williams story, mainly about their dad, how he coached them into becoming the tennis superstars that they are. It is it's definitely like not what I expected. I expected to just be more Venus and Serena story. It kind of turned out to be just like about him and his family and how he was with his family. And it was kind of interesting. I thoroughly enjoyed it. I was very surprised by this movie, actually. This movie was like really enjoyable on a surprising level, because Will Smith, same thing with Marvel with Will Smith. Sometimes he could be a little stale, and Will Smith kind of just plays Will Smith nowadays. So it's just kind of like, whatever, another Will Smith movie, who gives a shit? But this one was good. I give it to him. This one was really, really good, actually. So number 8. This one no one really knows about. This is just one I happened to stumble upon. And I'm glad I stumbled upon it. Number 8 is Pig, starring Nicolas Cage. And if you have not seen Pig, starring Nicolas Cage, I say go watch it. It's a slow burn, but it is the most well acted I've ever seen Nicolas Cage do. Nicolas Cage is usually over the fucking top every single movie he's in, but this he was so good. I teared up a little bit too at the end. So basically, he's just a pig farmer who sells mushrooms to people so they can use mushrooms to cook, like truffle mushrooms, like they're very expensive truffles. And he has this pig that goes out and finds those mushrooms. It's a specific pig. He only has one. Goes out, find those mushrooms to sell to people. And he makes money off of it. Then someone ends up kidnapping his pig. And then he just goes through the town trying to look for his pig. It kind of sounds like John Wick, but it ain't like John Wick. It's kind of a little bit more mellow than that. But it is like, it's definitely a character-based story on this guy and why he lives like alone in the woods with his pig. And just like, it's interesting. It's interesting and it's so good. Nicolas Cage in it is so great to me. I can't believe this movie existed in 2021 with Nicolas Cage, because he's actually really fucking good in this movie, and it actually shocks me. Go watch it if you've never seen it. Like I said, it is sort of a slow burn, but once you get into his story and once you get into them telling about his life, it's actually very interesting. Very interesting movie.
7.
Number 7 is Val. Now, Val is a documentary about Val Kilmer. And in this documentary is a bunch of footage that Val Kilmer would shoot back in the day. Like, he always had a camera on him and he always would like record anything that he would do, like in all the sets of the movies he's on, Batman, Top Gun, like he would just record everything. And it's about how he's like going through his life now, dealing with the fact that he can't do the things he used to do, and like just the way his life is living now compared to where it was. It's very interesting, kind of heartbreaking, because he has like, so apparently he had throat cancer, which I didn't even know about. Val Kilmer had throat cancer, and now he can't even talk. He can only speak through like a little box, like a little, you know how you seen like that one lady in the commercial where she has this little thing and she has to poke it through a hole in her throat? Like, that's what he has to do now. And I had no idea he was going through that at all. But that's the way he's living now. He can barely speak. And the fact that he's telling his story and he has his son narrate the whole thing. And it's funny because his son sounds just like him. And it's pretty crazy to see. It's a really heartwarming documentary. It's very nice to see. Like, I actually enjoyed this one. And to see like a lot of behind the scenes shit from all these old school classic films that he shot, you know, is always interesting. Always interesting to see. Like, so go watch Val. It's on Amazon Prime. It's about Val Kilmer. If you don't even like Val Kilmer as an actor, it doesn't matter. Still go watch it. It's still pretty good. I would say it's still pretty good.
6.
Number 6 on my list is Snyder Cut's Justice League. Justice League Snyder Cut. Snyder Cut Justice League. Justice League. Justice League. Snyder Cut. You know what I'm trying to say. Justice League Snyder Cut. This movie was so fucking good. I watched it, like, I've already seen it like 3 or 4 times already now. I've even seen the version in black and white just because I wanted to. And it's still fucking good. Just so you know, it's amazing fucking movie. As we know, Justice League came out theatrically, was poop as fuck. People hated it, and they realized that the studio just ripped through everything. They just cut through everything, just ripped out all the guts and juice and all the goodness of it, and just threw out some piece of shit. And so everybody was like, we need the Snyder Cut. Where's the Snyder Cut? We want that instead of this bullshit that we got. And we did. We got the Snyder Cut. And it's 4 hours long. It's 4 hours long. That should turn you off. That should have turned me off. 4 hours of Justice League? That's too long. But it didn't feel like it. I was upset when it ended. I was mad when it ended. Ain't that some shit? I was pissed off. I wanted more. That's how you know it's good. That's how you know it's good, bro. Like, Zack Snyder's Justice League, so fucking well done. Please go and watch it. If you've never seen Justice League Snyder Cut, go watch it. I don't care. Go watch it. Just watch it. You know what it's about. Fuck. I don't even have to explain what it's about. You know what it's about. Justice League, nigga. Damn.
Five.
So this is the top five now. We're in top five. Top five was hard, man. Top five is really, really tough to make. But I think I got a pretty good list, pretty good top five here. All right. If you guys don't like my top five, eat my asshole. Number five is Judas and the Black Messiah. Now, listen to me. Listen to me. Judas and the Black Messiah. Directed by Shaka King. Starring Daniel Kaluuya and Lakeith Stanfield. I'll throw Jesse Plemons in there. Why not? But Daniel Kaluuya and Lakeith Stanfield. If you've never seen Judas and the Black Messiah, it's about Fred Hampton.
Deputy Chairman Fred Hampton of the Illinois Black Panther Party.
Who was assassinated by the FBI because Lakeith Stanfield's character was a snitch. Was a traitor. Alright? He was giving information to the FBI so they can just end up killing this dude for no fucking reason at all. Just, you know, trying to help his community out. Not really a terrorist at all. But, you know. You know. Even if you know, you know. You know what I'm saying. You know what I'm talking about. But Judas and the Black Messiah was so fucking phenomenal. I watched it. And then right after I finished it, I watched it again. It's so good. Daniel Kaluuya in it is so great. Lakeith Stanfield is great in everything. I don't have to explain myself about him. He's already good in everything that he does. I always love learning about historic events. Like, that's the type of person I am. I enjoy watching things and learning things at the same time. That's just what I enjoy doing. That's why I love documentaries so much, because I always learn something new. So, this was no different at all. I enjoyed it. I enjoyed it a lot. Four. Alright, number four. So I put this one at number four for only my own personal reason. Just because I'm a simp. So number four is A Man Named Scott. It's a Kid Cudi documentary. I just did a review for this one. I told you guys, I'm a simp for Kid Cudi. This is how it is. I thoroughly enjoy anything about this man, so I threw his shit at number four. So, you know, it is what it is. I know it probably isn't number four on everyone else's list, but it is on mine, so I don't care. Just so you know, I love that documentary. Makes me weep, and I like to weep at good shit. All right?
Three.
Number three is The Green Knight. The Green Knight is directed by David Lowery and is starring Dave Patel. And I'm going to tell you right now, The Green Knight was just... it's one of those movies where I just sit down and I just watch and I just am in awe. I'm just like looking at it and I'm just like, this is the most gorgeous fucking thing I've ever seen in my entire life. It is so beautiful. It is just gorgeous, bro. I can't get over how much I love this movie. The way it looks, the way it's acted, the story. I didn't realize it was about King Arthur and fucking Galahad and all this other stuff. And I was just, it just kind of just like went over my head when I went into the movie theater. I didn't think about it at all. But once I started listening to the story and the story was developing, and I was just like, I've heard this before. And I've read this before when I was a younger kid in high school. So thoroughly enjoyed it. Loved it so much. It might not be for everybody, to be quite honest with you. It might not be for everybody, but it is definitely, it was for me. It's definitely like a fantasy world type of situation. Like a Lord of the Rings or maybe like a Hobbit type of situation. Definitely visually beautiful. Definitely well acted. The story's great and interesting. His journey to get to the Green Knight is also very interesting. Top two. I wonder if you guys can figure out what my top two is. I don't know if they're obvious, but I mean, maybe one might be obvious. One of them might be obvious, but I don't know if the other one's obvious for you. Number two. We have Spider-Man No Way Home. Number two is Spider-Man No Way Home. Obvious reasons why it's up there at number two. it's clear as day why it's up there at number two. It's the, come on. Maybe because it's just fresh in my mind right now that is it that high. But it's number two. It's number two. It's so good. So well done. Ugh. Yeah, I have my review for Spider-Man No Way Home. I'll put it up here somewhere, anywhere up here. I don't know. But Spider-Man No Way Home is number two for me. I think it's a solid movie, and it's a solid Marvel movie. All right? It's golden. It is golden. Oh, it's so good. I'm about to go watch it again. I'll watch it a third time in the movie theater. It's very rare that I see movies multiple times in the theater. I've seen this twice in the theater already, and I kind of want to go see it a third time. No shame. I got no shame about that. So my number one film, the best film of 2021, for me personally, movie that I loved the most for 2021, The Harder They Fall. The Harder They Fall is my pick for the best movie of 2021. It might not be your favorite, but it was definitely my favorite. Just alone, the acting, the you know, directed by James Samuels, Idris Elba, Zazie Beetz, Regina King, Jonathan Majors, Lakeith Stanfield, you know, RJ Seiler. Everyone's in this movie, and I loved it. I love this movie. I've seen this movie so many times now. You know what it is? It's like the thing with black cinema, we don't got much. We ain't got much. We just have like a lot of hood movies, a lot of slave movies, a lot of like police brutality type movies, and a lot of like, oh, let's do something sports wise and uplifting. That's about the genre. That's the categories in our genre for black films. So having like a movie where it's just us just doing some cool shit, it's pretty nice. It's feel good. Like I enjoy seeing us just black people being cowboys. What else could you ask for? Like I love seeing that shit. Like it's just thoroughly enjoyable to me. Like it's just a good fucking movie. And I kind of hope they make a sequel. Kind of hope they make another one, to be quite honest with you, because I thoroughly enjoyed this. So that was it. That's my top 10 of all time. Let me know in the comments what movie you've seen that was in my top 10 list. What's your favorite movie? What is your number one movie of the year? Let me know that. Tell me that. Try to get out some more reviews. We are working on editing a lot of videos for you guys right now. We have a lot of shit coming out fairly soon. We're working on getting more Game of Thrones out for you guys. We're definitely doing more original videos. We are going to be in full gear for 2022, okay? We are going to be coming in hot. We're trying out new things. I'm going to try to bring Showdowns back. And we will see you guys next year, all right? So like and subscribe to the channel, because we are in full effect going on our third year, all right? So thank you for watching, and we'll see you again soon, all right? Bye.